Hello dear students, I am Professor Mandar Dixit from Electrical Engineering Department. Today we are here to solve problem on maximum power transfer theorem. The statement of problem is calculate the value of RL for it to absorb maximum power and find out the maximum power in the circuit. The circuit is given, we have to calculate the value of RL for which the power transfer from source to RL will be maximum, and the second part is we have to calculate that value of maximum power transferred from source to RL. Let us start the problem. The first step of the problem will be, according to maximum power transfer theorem, maximum power will be transferred from circuit to the load RL when RL is made equal to equivalent resistance, which is Thevenin's resistance RL across terminals A and B. In the circuit, we will mark the load terminals. These are terminals A and B, which are marked across RL. The RL will be made equal to equivalent resistance of the existing circuit. To calculate this equivalent resistance, we will follow the procedure of calculation of RTH in Thevenin's circuit. Remove load RL and replace the voltage source with short circuit. Then our circuit will modify as here the battery or source 120 volt is replaced by short circuit and A and B terminals are opened. Their RL resistance is removed from the circuit. The equivalent resistance across AB will be called as RTH. From the circuit, we observe that 40 ohm resistor and 20 ohm resistor are connected in parallel as they are connected to same point. Hence, these two resistances can be converted into single resistance. So, our circuit will modify further. The value of parallel combination of 40 ohm and 20 ohm will be this resistor, and the value is 13.33 ohm. Again, in the modified circuit, 60 ohm and 13.33 ohm are connected in series. Hence, resistance across AB, which is RTH, is equal to series combination of 60 and 13.33. Hence, we can write down as RTH is equal to 73.33 ohm. According to maximum power transfer theorem, maximum power will be absorbed when the load resistance becomes equal to equivalent resistance. RTH is the equivalent resistance of the given circuit. Hence, we get RL as 73.33, which is equal to RTH. This is answer of first part. Then we have to calculate Pmax. The formula for calculation of Pmax, we have to calculate VTH. Let us calculate VTH. For calculation of VTH, we will redraw the circuit. The VTH will be voltage across the open circuited terminals, that is AB. For calculation of VTH, we will follow the path from A to B, which is shown by this dotted line. Hence, VTH will be equal to voltage drop across 60 ohm resistor plus voltage drop across 20 ohm resistor. As 60 volt resistance is connected with open circuited terminals, hence no current flows through 60 ohm resistor. Therefore, VTH will be equal to only voltage drop across 20 ohm resistance. We will mark the current flowing in the circuit, which is I. By Ohm's law, we can calculate this I as (120/40+20), that is 2 ampere. As 40 ohm and 20 ohm become series for this current path, hence I will get as 2 ampere. Then VTH will be VAB, that is voltage across 20 ohm plus voltage across 60 ohm. That is 20 into I plus 60 into I. Substitute value of I. For 60, I is 0. Then we will get VTH as 40 volt. 20 into 2, 40 volt, and 60 into 0, that is 0. From this, we can calculate P max as, the formula for P max is 4 in VTH square divided by 4 into RTH. Substitute value of VTH and RTH. Then we will get P max as 5.45 watt. This is the maximum power transferred from source to load when RL is equal to equivalent resistance RTH, which is proved from the theorem. Thank you for watching this video.